Well, hi there. It's Electra. I'm outside of Angels and Kings Chicago. It's Pete Wentz's new club. He opened one up in New York City, and now he's coming home, baby. We're getting our own. So we're here for the big opening party, which is kind of like a combo birthday party for Pete, I think, too. So he's going to be here in a little bit. We are on the red carpet. I don't know if you can see, but hopefully we'll be able to grab him and chat with him about the new place, and I'm excited. We're going to get inside in a bit, too. Pete Wentz and Ashley are here. Aw, they pose very well. They're actually a very cute couple. You know, I've only ever seen them, you know, on, like, Perez Hilton or on blogs, and they actually look really cute together. My dad would probably come to a bar I was opening, especially if the drinks were free. Hey, just waiting. Here's an attractive looking man. I've said that louder than I meant to. I think we're next. Hey Pete, Electra from Q101. Hi. The Mana Brothers are on the air, or else they'd come by and say hey, but I know you'll get a chance to talk to them later.
Excellent.
Congratulations on opening the new place. I used to live around this neighborhood, so I know it's a good area to have a new club, and it needs a new place where bands can maybe come and hang out.
We do. We got a live stage, so hopefully somebody will play.
Now, I know there was that promoter's ordinance that was being talked about a couple of months ago. Would that be something that would end up affecting you guys?
I mean, we're pirates, so we'd probably go ahead and do it anyway, you know, but I don't know. It seems like it was tabled, but I don't really know the latest.
Yeah, I know they're probably talking about doing something further down the road with it, but that's the sort of atmosphere you want, where it's someplace fun, you would go and hang out, and the unexpected might happen?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, not per se tonight, but I think in general, hopefully somebody will play.
Right.
Maybe switch it up a little bit.
Because that's the type of bar you would want to hang out in, is someplace that's not the usual bar where you just go and hang.
I definitely don't want to hang in the usual bar. I want to hang in the unusual bar.
So what would make Angels and Kings unusual?
Well, we have a gong. We have like a 3-foot gong in there. And anytime anybody hits the gong, you get a free shot. And we have mug shots. We have 4 solid gold AK-47s on the wall, which are pretty cool.
And was that something that you had a hand in designing, all of that?
Well, I bought the guns. They're not working, actually. For anyone who's freaking out right now, they don't work. They were cemented and done by this artist, Peter Gronquist. They're dipped in gold, and then they're covered in like luxury prints. So there's like a Gucci gun in there. There's a Louis Vuitton one. There's a couple. They're cool.
So if you ever want a place where you could see a Louis Vuitton gun, Angels and Kings Chicago is the place.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, congratulations on the new bar. We'll be back soon, I'm sure.
Thanks,
Pete. We're in the middle of the pack now. Just talked to Pete. Gold-plated guns, Louis Vuitton guns, and a gong. Angels and Kings Chicago. Welcome.
Hey, what's up? I'm Kevin Mano from Q101.1, standing inside Angels and Kings with the two guys responsible for Angels and Kings. I guess you guys are both part owners,
yeah.
Is that what you said?
Absolutely.
It's your club, Pete and Nick. And they're going to kind of give us a little tour.
One of the big things we have in Angels and Kings, we have one in New York,
right,
as well, and one of our big themes was mugshots. Musician mugshots. So people a lot of times ask where the name Angels and Kings came from, and these are two of my managers, and JD was in a band called in the 80s called the Electric Angels, and Bob was in a band called the Step Kings, so we kind of combined the two together. But
it's so great. They're not real mugshots, those
two. No, those are fake ones.
Okay, right.
We got the height chart back here, so like you can come in and take your own mugshot, which is kind of like one of the cool parts, and we're gonna put some of them online.
Yeah,
in trouble.
Come on, get me.
Here's the thing, the New York one, it made you shorter, and that was a bummer. That always bummed me out, because I was like, I'm already a short dude. I don't need to be like, I can't lose 2 inches. I can't afford 2 inches.
Yeah.
You know? So,
yeah.
The antlers, I think, is a Nick. Is this kind of like a Nick thing?
Sure, yeah, it's me and Matt kind of love the antlers thing. It's also one of his bars. It has a lot of antlers, kind of Italian.
Yeah. And is this, would you call it a bar or a club? Is it going to be, what's the status with getting in? Is it a nightclub at all? I mean,
anyone can get in.
Yes. Could I come here at 6 p.m. on a Saturday and get a beer?
No.
No, we'll be open.
8 p.m. on Saturday. You should be all good.
I can wait in line. You can wear
whatever shoes you want.
Yeah, you got to pregame it at your house.
Yeah.
Tail, you have this, like stucco done. You are barred those colors. And then, obviously, mugshots. You have Sid and you have Jimi Hendrix.
Right.
Which, kind of a staple of the
Where did that come? You kind of briefly explained it, but why the mugshots?
Like, I just had the idea. Like, I was like, what if you went into a bar and you saw all the mugshots of, you know, musicians? You know, I think that was really cool. And there's a time before TMZ when you actually have to dig and find the mugshots, you know, whatever. Now they're out right away, but it's like, I hadn't even seen a couple of these.
Did you consider Nick Nolte at all?
DJ Booth Build-Out's cool. It's different than the New York one. I don't like people to be able to reach DJs because I hate when I'm DJing. I hate it when people are like, yeah, why don't you play the new Britney Spears song? You're like, that song sucks, dude. But the song might be good, maybe.
This is gone. Anytime anyone thanks gone, everybody in the bar gets shots.
I was in this gallery in LA called Gallery 1988, and this guy Peter Gronquist did these like luxury AK-47s where he cements the gun and then dips them in gold and then creates these, so like, you know, Gucci one.
Is it actually Gucci?
No. Yeah. Okay. He just goes crazy and like, I think it's like, what is that, peacock feathers?
Yeah.
Yeah. And he just goes crazy and they're dipped in gold, and we need to ship them here, which is crazy because nobody wants to ship an AK-47. So one of the things I learned from the New York bar is people draw on your wall no matter what you have on it. So what we did was we painted this with chalkboard paint, and then
That's awesome.
Yeah, and then obviously, you know, called it a designated graffiti area. I don't know if you can see it on the camera right here. And then put out chalk and just let people kind of go to town.
You're gonna have chalk in here?
Yeah, we have chalk in here. These are all, this is from the you know, whatever soft opening we have. This is already what it's covered in. But people really like drawing whatever they want.
Right.
You know, that's the thing, that's one of the things we really learned.
People write the most asinine things in the bathroom.
Yeah, totally. And the thing is, I was like, you know what? People are already gonna do it. So it's like, why don't we just do it, you know, whatever. Of course.
What's going on with FOB?
Right now, we're writing. We're in, you know, California. Obviously, I was in California yesterday, and that's where Patrick is. And
do you call California home now?
Yeah, I do. I call it home because that's where, like, I guess I own the house or whatever. But the thing is, I'm trying to convince my parents to sell me their place.
Still?
Yeah. Okay. Totally. I've been talking about it more and more, especially my wife isn't. And it's like, I want to raise a family here. I like, I just think it's a better environment than California. It's just, I mean, I don't even mean to say it in a weird way, but like, it's slower and like, a really good way. Like, there's just not people standing outside your house and trying to, you know, it's just a more real place, you know.
I mean, I've never seen paparazzi in Chicago.
Yeah, it's just a different vibe, which I like, you know, and it's just genuine. I try to avoid it as much as possible. Like, I don't think that it does anything, and I think that, like, celebrity culture, like, stars are just like us, is really boring and vapid. It's not really interesting, especially if you do something else. Like, if you are an actor or you're in a band, it's not really, it's like, oh, like, there's, you know, Chris Martin on the street or something. It's like, dude, you're like, I would rather just listen to his record, kind of, you know, or see him on stage, you know, see a picture of that. So it's something that I try to avoid. And Chicago's a good place, actually, to avoid it.
Where are you shooting your new your MTV stuff?
We shoot that in L.A. on a lot in L.A.
Are you shooting it every week?
Yeah, it's every week. So I fly in, do that, and then I come back here.
And do you want to, I mean, it's on Friday nights.
So on Friday nights, it's called FNMTV, and it's our attempt to kind of put the video back into a position of importance and have videos that the V in MTV actually mean something.
And both of you, congratulations on this place. I hope it does incredibly well for you. Thanks for showing us around and taking some time to talk to us. We appreciate it.
Of course.
And congrats again on the family.
Thank you. Appreciate
the wedding and the child. So.
Thank you.
Congrats.
Awesome.
Angels and Kings. Thanks, guys. I'm Kevin Mano. It's Q101.1.